Welcome to the BioBalance HealthCast, episode number 445, Pricing Alternatives for Testosterone and Estrogen Delivery Systems. BioBalance Health features conversations about anti-aging medicine. Your hosts are Dr. Kathy Maupin, Medical Director of BioBalance Health, and a leading expert in treating symptoms of aging, and Brett Newcomb, a licensed professional counselor. Dr. Maupin and Brett are the authors of The Secret Female Hormone, the seminal work about testosterone replacement therapy for women, and Got Testosterone, the newly released book for men that helps men choose the most effective and safe form of T replacement. These books are available on Amazon or from Dr. Maupin's office at BioBalance Health in St. Louis and in Kansas City. Dr. Maupin's office is currently accepting new patients.
So I was telling you about a patient that actually sent an email this week. She wanted to have, she's been having pellets for a long time, and she wanted to have a cheaper alternative. So she asked me what a cheaper alternative would be and how she could, get it.
Right.
So at that point, prices change with bioidentical compounding pharmacies often. So I had to do a little research, and I thought I'd share that research with you. When women look at pricing for estrogen and testosterone, it's two hormones. So if you go to a pharmacy of any kind, it's two prescriptions.
Yeah, because you have to have each one identified in a prescription.
Right. So it's estrogen. They don't mix it together. They used to, but they don't. They have figured out how not to do that. Okay. So they, if it's in a vaginal tab, it's a cream, it's a gel, it's a sublingual tablet, then those all those have to be priced separately.
So you have to buy your estrogen. That's one cost.
And then they have to buy your testosterone. That's another.
Okay.
And most compounding pharmacies aren't in your area, so usually you have to have a shipping fee, which is significant because it has to be cool. They can't melt. So it usually has. It's usually $25 a month to ship it.
Yeah, you get them in these little refrigerator envelope things that are chilled.
So that it can't melt because that's partially how some of these are delivered. They melt under your tongue. They melt in the vagina.
Right.
So with body heat. So when I looked at that, I added or I compared the monthly cost of the average dose of pellets, which is one estradiol of, we have many doses, one of those and all the doses are cost the same, and two of the testosterones. And I took that plus the insertion fee. When people come in for the office visit is called an insertion fee because they come in, they talk to my nurse practitioners, they get their pellets inserted, and the pellets are in that one fee. So they come in three times a year, but I took this and divided it up so it was once a month. What would the monthly cost be?
Yeah. So you can make the comparison.
Yeah.
Because if they're going to the pharmacy, they're getting a month's worth.
Right.
Okay.
So just to make it apples and apples.
Right.
But I'm going to say here, it's not apples and apples anyway.
Right.
However, because pellets are superior in how they work, and we are superior in
the
what we do.
The consistency of the dosage.
The dosage is even throughout the day. The dosage of all the other forms go up and down all day long, and that doesn't feel good to most women or most men. So dosing is very important, and also women don't always give themselves their dose. They forget. And you can't forget if you get a pellet. The other thing is we offer all kinds of other service at the same time as we do pellets. We adjust your thyroid, or we do preventive treatment for diabetes or high blood pressure. So all of these things are included in this.
Yeah.
So it's not really
in the insertion fee.
In the insertion fee, which is not included in your pharmacy fee.
Right.
So so you'd have to add an office visit to this to actually be apples and apples, and it still wouldn't be. In any case.
And that varies by doctor and location. Wherever you are when you go to your pharmacy, you go to your doctor, you have to add those costs together to have a comparison.
So when we took the average insertion plus pellet fee, it ended up being $142.70 a month. When we looked at an estrogen of any type, sublingual, vagitab, gel, any of those, and a testosterone of any of those different bioidentical types, then we found that they were even. They were $142.70 because you had to put in shipping.
Right.
So with these two options, the option that is obviously the best and the most effective and the safest and the most consistent is pellets. So there really isn't a difference. The difference to me is that you have to pay for 4 months at a time with the pellets and with the sublinguals and the other bioidenticals.
So for women, it's a wash in terms of cost.
Right.
But the advantage is the visit with the doctor is included. Mm-hmm. And there's that opportunity
visit
to have other things.
Visit with the nurse practitioner.
Doctor or nurse practitioner. But you have other things checked out, like diabetes issues or thyroid issues, because you're there with the doctor who can, or nurse practitioner who can do what needs to be done.
Right.
And that's included in that
standard
price.
In the insertion
price.
Fee.
Yes.
Now, when we start patients off, we do hour-long consultations. That's separate.
Well, but it's
and not, that's usually reimbursed by every insurer except Medicare.
Except Medicare. So I spoke in error a minute ago. It's not a wash because we don't factor in the cost of the doctor visit in the
pharmacy. In the pharmacy.
All the pharmacy costs and shipping costs are
even
comparable.
But
you got to add a doctor visit to that.
Right.
So that cost adds on top.
And that could be a copay for you, or it could be a whole doctor's visit. And most people who do bioidentical hormones are cash.
Mm-hmm.
So they aren't insurance based. So they're not reimbursed as high a level.
Right.
For us, you just need a doctor's visit at the beginning to get you started and organized and figured out what your maintenance dose is. And then for a year, you just come in for the insertions.
Right.
But you get to talk to the nurse practitioner who knows a lot. A lot of the places, not for women that I've heard of, but for men, you go in and you get a shot either every week or every other week by a nurse who doesn't know anything. She says, don't ask me any questions. I mean, I've heard this a million times from the places around here. Don't ask me any questions. I don't know anything. Here's your shot. Bye. And that's it. I mean, so we compared the men's delivery systems of testosterone, and that was quite different. So we're going to show you in a bar graph.
Yes, yes. And we have one that we're looking at, and you can see it up here.
See it up here. So when we took men's cost at BioBalance, it's usually about $1,200 twice a year. So it's $2,400
right.
for a year. And that ends up being about $200 a month. But we were surprised when we found out that...
Which is about $50 a month higher than women's comparatively, but men need a lot more.
A lot more testosterone.
The volume of testosterone
right.
is a lot
But
higher.
They only come in twice.
They only come in twice.
And women come in three times because we can't get as much testosterone as men get.
Right.
At one time, it would be just too much for us.
So I have a friend that called me because our new book, Got Testosterone, which is a testosterone replacement book for men.
On pellets.
Covering all of the issues involved in do you need it, how do you know you need it, what are your symptoms, what are the treatments, and so on. And he called me and he said, I got your book and I'm reading it. It makes a lot of sense to me, but I'm concerned about the cost. So he had gone to one of the high-volume clinics here
in St.
Louis.
Well, we can say the name of it. It's Men's Clinic.
Men's Clinic. And they told him it would cost him about $4,000 a year. So he decided, even though his testosterone numbers were low and he could identify most of the symptoms, and he said, man, I'm just not feeling good, but...
For $4,000 a year, he'd have to go into their office and get a shot every week.
Okay.
That is off... I mean, if I were the man, it wouldn't work for my schedule. It wouldn't work for your schedule.
And it's not
even
something they'll
retired.
Let him do at home.
No. So you have to go in and get your shot. You have to be in town.
Right.
So, I mean, you're...
Or miss a week.
Or if you're on vacation for 2 weeks, then you're missing 2 weeks. So that was the cost of the treatment, but not the cost of your time. I mean, the cost of an hour twice a year versus an hour every week is
right.
a lot.
Right. And that wasn't factored into any of his consideration because he I don't think he knew that at the time. He just knew what the total cost was going to be. So then he went back to his regular physician, and the guy said, well, you know... There are some other alternatives. One is we could give you a testosterone patch.
Mm-hmm.
He said, well, how much is that going to cost? And they told him what the price was. And they said, check with your insurance.
It's $400 to $600.
A month. So he checked with his insurance.
That's amazing.
And they said, well, that'd be $4,000 a year too. And so he decided, nah, I don't think I'm going to do that. I don't have that
Depends
kind of money.
Depends on the patch. Some of them are even more.
But then he aged out of his insurance and got Medicare.
Right.
So he called Medicare and said, I'm got these low testosterone numbers, and I really want to get some help with that. What would it cost me to get a testosterone patch? And right. they said, nothing. It's covered.
So Medicare discounts all of these things. They suck it up and pay the pharmaceutical company. So, and they have discounted rates because they're Medicare. But what do we do with the men between 45 and 65,
right.
20 years, who need testosterone?
And who don't have $4,000 a year to pay for it.
Right. I mean, so that's huge. But so,
and my concern about my friend, and you and I were talking mm-hmm. about him, and his, because he had somewhat.
But it's still not apples and apples.
No, it's not, because the testosterone patch is not the same thing as a testosterone pellet. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of side effect concerns with the patch that you don't have with the pellets.
Right. The patches are, when they go through your skin, they're put on, if they're put on your arm, and there's some patches you have to put on your testicles, believe it or not. That just depends on what type, but one goes on your arm, and let's just talk about that one. So this one makes a lot of estrogen just to get through your skin. It's not bioidentical, so that's one thing. And as it goes through your skin, it makes a lot of estrogen. So generally what happens is the first month you feel great because you haven't been making much estrogen.
Yeah.
But as it builds up, you feel worse and worse and worse, and the patch doesn't work. So they write you two patches and then just double that cost.
So I remember the horror stories about the nicotine patches that rolling over in bed, they transfer to your wife
yeah.
and stick to her leg or arm
yeah.
or what have you. Or if you were carrying your kid around, that would be a concern.
Well, the patches are safer than the jells. The jells, if you're taking, if you put your jell underneath your arm and then you're carrying your granddaughter or grandson around, and then you can transfer that testosterone and the estrogen that it makes, because jells make a lot of estrogen as well.
Yeah.
Then that is not good for your grandchildren. So when that all came out and
right.
they brought that up to the public, all of a sudden the jell price plummeted.
I'll bet it did.
They brought it down. So for the cheapest testosterone for men is the jell, and it's $150 a month.
And it's called Androgel.
Androgel.
Yeah.
So that's, but you got to remember to put it on, and you have to remember not to touch your kids and wash your hands afterwards. I mean,
right.
that's a big deal too. Honestly, it takes a lot of time. So then we went to the pharmacy Androderm,
mm-hmm.
which is another kind of patch, and that was $620 a month.
Yeah, so it's $7,000 a year.
So pellets are $200 for average dose for men, which is 1,800 milligrams. That's $200 a month. And
you don't have to remember to put it on like you do a patch
or a gel. You just have to show up twice a year.
You can hug your wife. You can hug your grandkids. You can do all of that.
You can't get in a bathtub for 3 days after it's inserted. So twice a year, you can't get in a bathtub or a pool for 3 days.
You have to take showers.
You have to take showers.
Yeah.
So I don't find that to be a real hardship. And we don't like you to exercise for a couple days afterwards either. That's 4 days out of your life. Four days out of 365. So that shouldn't be a problem either. Honestly, it's much easier and much less expensive and much more effective to get the pellets.
Yeah.
But when your friend asked all this,
right.
I was actually surprised that Medicare would pay for it. And that Medicare, because Medicare will pay for like six Viagra a month. Six. That's it.
So I don't know that that's an accurate statement from him. I know that's what he believes, what he was told.
Okay.
We haven't verified that independently.
Yeah.
But he was stunned by the difference between what his insurance formulary would pay before with the insurance that he had and Medicare.
Uh-huh.
But then I started talking to him about the difference between the patch and the pellet and why you only do pellets. I mean, used to do all of those things.
I used to do all that stuff, but it never worked well. I mean, I'd have to always say, well, this is all we can do, and sorry, we can't make you better. And yeah, if we use this, we've got to deal with all these other side effects, and I don't have to do that anymore. People come in and go, I'm better. We got that email from
another male. A different male, yes.
Who had been doing pellets 7 years ago, did it for 2 years. During that time, he lost 20 pounds. He's a salesman. His sales went up by 300%.
He was that much sharper.
His brain was sharper. He had more energy. His muscle mass went up, and everybody asked him what he was doing, because did he have a facelift or what? Because he looked like 20 years younger. So he then had a financial issue. So he stopped doing pellets, and he said, I'm going to go to this other clinic where somebody's in my family is working and I'll get the family discount. And so he went there and he had to go in every week, and he was a traveling kind of in travel sales.
Mm-hmm.
He was working and
so it was hard to schedule getting in at that time when they were open to get his shots.
I mean, most men have a hard time just getting in twice a year. I can't imagine getting in once a week.
Yeah.
And he would go without it all the time and then feel terrible. He said he gained 30 pounds on the shots and he felt terrible. And he's coming. So this was all written on his intake form to come back to us.
Right.
Because we have to do the whole history and everything again, because everything's changed in that many years. So this was impressive that it was so different.
And for those men for whom cost is a question, when my friend called me, I didn't have these numbers. I mean, mm-hmm. we've had this conversation and you did the research. So I'm able to go back to my friend and say, comparatively, it is a very cost-effective and time-effective treatment mm-hmm. that generates the best results, the safest.
Right.
And that's what I want to say to him. And I'm not trying to sell your business to him.
No, but it actually is.
But it is that's, true.
It's
and
why
now we have the numbers to say so.
You know, for years I used all these other forms. I've used all the forms of hormones. And, you know, if that's all you've got, I mean, if there is no pellet, if there was no pellet, then I guess it's better to have some hormone
than nothing. Right.
But if you can get pellets, it's not more expensive, obviously, unless you're on Medicare. And it is something that is much more effective and can bring you all the way back to health, not just a little bit better, not just get rid of, for women, hot flashes or get rid of anxiety attacks or give you a little bit more muscle.
Right.
But it's really good.
It's worth it.
And it really works.
Please check it out. Thank you for listening.
Email your questions or comments to podcast@biobalancehealth.com. You can find the BioBalance HealthCast on iTunes and on YouTube. For more information about bioidentical hormone pellet therapy and other reverse aging solutions, visit biobalancehealth.com or call 314-993-0963. You can find Dr. Maupin on Twitter at Dr. Kathy Maupin and on Facebook at facebook.com/biobalancehealth. Find Brett Newcomb at brettnewcomb.com.